Okay, so now coming towards our next point, next term, that is expense. What we mean by expense? See, first of all, you must be aware of that the expenditure and expenses are two different terms. As we have said, that expenditure is the amount that is to be, that is expended today, that is spent today for getting the future in benefits. Just like that, expenses are also the amount spent, but the difference is that it is basically the cost incurred for generating revenue. Expenditure was the cost incurred for getting benefits, but expense is the cost incurred for generating revenue. For taking some examples of expenses such as salaries paid to the staff. Obviously, your staff members will gonna help you to generate revenue in future, and for that you are paying salaries to your staff member. Next one is depreciation. Depreciation is basically a cost but a non-cash expense. Non-cash expense in which you will neither saw that the cash is either inflowed or outflowed, but still the expense is made as the value of your asset will be decreased because of charging of depreciation. The next example of expense is bad debts. Depreciation is charged on the capital asset, but bad debts is the expense of daily nature, is on current assets, that is debtors. The next example of expense is decline in value of asset. Say devaluation of investment. Okay, this is what our expense means, that is the cost incurred for generating revenue. See, salaries helps in generating revenue. Depreciation is done for asset. So if we have made some purchase of asset, then the value will ultimately depreciate it. But the depreciation is done because of use of that asset. So it's the use of that asset will help in generating the revenue. Similarly, bad debts are basically written over the current asset, that is on debtors. If you will make some sales on credit basis, only then you will be able to earn more sales. So to increase your sales, you are required to sell your product on credit basis, and for that you also have to incur your expense named as bad debts. Similarly, there is also the other expense known as devaluation in investment. If you will invest today, in long run you will earn profit in that, but in short run you will see that investment value is continuously either declining or increasing as well. So for that increase you have to wait for some period of time, and in that period of time you need to face the expense known as devaluation in the investment. So now discussing about the types of expenses. Expenses are divided into two types. First one is prepaid expense and other is outstanding expense. Now let us discuss what we mean by these two types of expenses. First of all, coming towards our first expense, that is prepaid expense. As the name suggests, these are prepaid. That is, we have paid these expenses before earnings, before utilizing its benefits. So we can say that prepaid expenses are basically those expenses that has been paid in advance. And the benefit of which will be available in the following years or the years you have to face in the future. For example, you have paid salary to your staff for the year 2018 and 2017. So it's obvious that the staff will gonna work in 2018 as well, and they are want to work in 2018 as well, and that's why the expense is paid in advance. So we will call it prepaid expense, prepaid salaries. Prepaid salaries you have paid today for benefit in 2018. Okay, this is what we mean by prepaid salaries, prepaid expenses. Okay, now coming towards our next expense, that is outstanding expense. As the name says, outstanding, that is those expenses which are yet to be made, already standard to be paid in future, for which you have utilized its benefits today. So outstanding expenses are basically those expenses the payment of which is to be made in future for those benefits which you have utilized today, for which you have taken the benefits today. Okay, taking an example of outstanding expenses, say outstanding commission. Outstanding commission. What do you mean by commission? It's basically the expense you have to make to your broker or some other agent from which you have taken any of your office service. So say you have taken service today. Service is taken from the agent. Say insurance agent today. But you don't have amount to pay today, so you promised him to pay after 1 month. So such expenditure you will write off in your account as outstanding commission. Thank you. With this, we have completed our expense term as well. Now let us discuss where the entry of outstanding as well as prepaid expense is to be written. Being an expense, the entry of both the expenses are to be written on the debit side of P&L account, that is profit and loss account. But apart from this, if we are required to post the prepaid or outstanding expense in the balance sheet, then in case of balance sheet, prepaid expenses are to be written off in the asset side as the benefit of such expenses are to be taken in future, so it is an asset. But in case of outstanding expense for which you are liable to pay in future, it is basically a future expenditure, so it will be written off in the liability side of balance sheet. Okay, with this the expenses are completed. Hope you like our video, and for further videos please download our app Scholars Learning, and if you have already downloaded our app, hope you are enjoying it.